lift your two hands unto the Lord. Let's start it again.
Oh,
come to God, not unto man. He will touch you. Yes, Yamia. Oh,
yeah.
Savior that we have met. He is a wonderful God. We can sing, we can dance, we can shout, we can say whatever because of the Savior that we have met. Marching kwa Messiano, Nabe. When I pray, then I sleep. Then the Holy Spirit opened my eye. Then I saw my father. Then he was pointing to me so many things. Then he was telling me, Mercy, you see all these things. They are all vain things. I had it all. But none of them helped me. Hold on to that which you have taken. You have taken the best of all. Don't regret when you're working for God. For there is a great reward awaits you. Brothers and sisters in Christ, if you don't know anything at all in your life, throw away your pride and step on it like this. Amen. And be humble before Him. Amen. There is something I learned when I went home. The death of my father went so deep into my heart. But the Lord told me, you see, they brought you to this earth. I use them just as a person to blame you. I influence you along today. Their time is over. If there is any tears to say, say that you will know me, you must die. So I told my siblings, when we went, the money we sent, everything, they've messed all the time. They brought me another list that we have to buy things for them to use to bury. A whole lot. I didn't know that when somebody died, they need so many things. So that before that day, I was in suit. So I told my sister, don't you think Papa wanted me to buy his suit from you? She said, ah, but you sent the money to them already. The following day, I was giving suit. I said, ah, just as I heard the bell press, I opened, I saw the last one. And I said, they said I should bring this to you. Not though they've not bought anything to close them, to bury them. So that is why the Holy Spirit was revealing to me, suit. I told myself, I won't even bury them with suit anymore. I'll put them close, put on clothes for them like a chief and a queen. But after everything I said, ow! All these expensive clothes, they are going to put it on the ground. Brothers and sisters, if you are alive today and you cannot give your all to Jesus, die for Jesus, walk with Jesus, eat with Jesus, talk to Jesus, and throw away your pride. Now, Christianity has become something that you don't want to be. Hey, this person wants to stop the church. You stop the church. You are not stopping the church. You stop working on your salvation. Because whenever Jesus went, he also faced the problems and the challenges we are facing. He never gave up. If we are giving up, you and me will not be here. We talk too much. I can tell something. When God opened my eyes, I see that you don't love God. You are coming to church, you have to come. It's like by force school. But if you know their benefits after you leave this earth, you won't even let anybody tell you, brother, serve God and serve. Anybody who loves God can easily forgive. What a thought has somebody done to you that you can't even forgive the person? You look down upon the person. You see the person going good like this. Even you are in the spirit praying. Somebody please open your eyes and see the person. Hey! If you walk with somebody who cannot easily forgive you, know that the person does not know Jesus. We only want it on silver platter. God will bless you. God will keep you, preserve you. If the Holy Spirit is coming to you and you are holding on to a cross with a sister, I tell you, that's why some of you get tired, you go to church, powerful church like this. Some of you are still in trouble. Your heart is too full of dirty things. Throw them away. And allow God to walk into your life. One day, everything, we have everything. Today, I was telling Pastor that if my father of hope was dead and going to bury him, everybody would die. Because the way my father is, for them to bury the way they were pouring their son, whatever. So my father has buried a lot of people today to their new one. We are buried. We are their son. We will go back to soil. Let us stop complaining. Some of you can complain now than I ask Pastor. Do they know Jesus? If they don't know Jesus, they'll complain like this, and the warriors. We want to work with people who want to work with Jesus. Because Jesus sent us here. So if you don't know Jesus, you will worry us, and what our wish is that all of us should be saved. But if there is evil grammar, they don't want to listen to the word of God. Hey, God will flash you. We are in the last days. Don't let anybody beg you to serve God. No. A time is coming when you really wish, you wish to get somebody to say, Jesus is alive. Nobody will tell you. We are in dispensation of grace. Walk with God. Talk to God. Don't wait until you come to stand before you say Matthew 7, 7. You don't know even what is there. When we talk of John 10:10, you go to John 10:30. No. Let Christianity be real on you. You are happy when you all is well with you. When all is not well with you, everybody to shut up. Who are you? I said, if my father of all people today is there, and be dead, everybody want to go. I tell some things you don't think is real until it happens to you. Value Christ. Some people cannot come to church on Fridays. Just the one person was in their chair. Looking back, when I came back to Israel, all those who are brothers will tell you. Some people can complain, my baby, I'm like, who are you? Who are you? We are nine. But when my father died, it takes how many people to bury you? Think about yourself and your salvation. The doctors want to take this baby through the snow. They say this and that. We cover the kinder by the way. The robber, we bring him. One day without me meeting as children of God, you know what the enemy will do? You are not enough, but I'm not enough from you. I've allowed myself, and I'm determined to move in Christ. Do so. So that when we are talking of Jesus, somebody can say, with this woman, I'll go to church. Give your all to him. He's the owner of your soul and your body. Even if they are cutting your hand and you can't walk, do like this. Come. Don't look at bad people to influence you in the house of God. The bad ones, they talk too much. They influence too much. Remember, we are in the last days. People to stop you from serving God, we are many. Take instructions and let us move. By all means, you'll get there. Let's go to us to God. Say, Lord Jesus,
today
I dedicate my body,
my spirit, my soul
unto you. I don't want to serve you halfway and give up along the way. I want to finish with you so that I will enjoy eternity in Jesus' mighty name. Today the Holy Spirit was talking to me to tell everybody to dedicate all your children to God. Say, dedicate them unto God. Somebody will say, Mama, some of the children have been dedicated already. The Holy Spirit said, we should dedicate all of them to God. When you dedicate something to God, that means you are giving God the full authority to rule and reign. It does not, whether you have children or not, let us take it serious. He is the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. He knows what is awaiting us. That's why I said we should do this. The Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
As my hands are lifted unto you, I dedicate all my children now and yet to be born, my great grandchildren, unto you, God. And wherever they are, let them be yours. Order their steps. Protect and preserve them. Have mercy upon them. Let these hands never witness the burial of any of my offspring in the mighty name of Jesus. Now on your own, in your own words, talk to God concerning your children. Le carabu stebedi matosa. Labrador korobo stebedi. Le borobo stebedi karima sote atarwa. Bring them to Jesus once again. Alimo korobo stebedi matosele. They go to places where we don't even know of. They eat from places we don't even know of. Alimo korobo stebedi masoria tarawa. Ilabra do korobo stebedi matosele terebo. Let the Lord watch over them. In the mass of the